नमस्ते ऑल स्टूडेंट्स, अ वेरी वार्म वेलकम टू ऑल। माई सेल्फ जेबीएन डॉक्टर हेमंत व्यास, एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर एंड हेड ऑफ डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ सर्जरी, फैकल्टी ऑफ होम्योपैथिक साइंस, ज्योति विद्यापीठ, वुमेन्स यूनिवर्सिटी, जयपुर। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट एलर्जिक राइनाइटिस। इन अवर प्रीवियस लेक्चर्स वी हैव डिस्कस अबाउट क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ राइनाइटिस, डेफिनेशन ऑफ राइनाइटिस एंड फ्यू टाइप्स ऑफ राइनाइटिस। एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट एलर्जिक राइनाइटिस, विच इज अ इम्पॉर्टेंट टाइप ऑफ नॉन स्पेसिफिक और नॉन इन्फेक्टिव राइनाइटिस। सो लेट्स सी वेयर द व्हाट इज वेयर इज द प्लेस ऑफ एलर्जिक राइनाइटिस इन द क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ राइनाइटिस। So as we have seen earlier that rhinitis is divided into infective rhinitis and non-infective rhinitis. So allergic rhinitis is basically the type of non-infective rhinitis, in which the other type we have also said in previous lecture that vasomotor rhinitis is also a type of non-infective rhinitis. Okay, but today we are going to discuss about allergic rhinitis. So students, this is an important topic from exam point of view also and your practice point of view also, because homeopathy is known for treatment of allergies, and we have excellent results in cases of allergies. Homeopathic medicine can annihilate or completely remove the allergies from the person. Because the treatment of allergies is very difficult and it involves antihistamines and steroids, which have their own side effects. So the patient tries to avoid these side effects, and many of the patients try homeopathy. And homeopathy is second largest system now after allopathy, which is mostly used by the people of so many countries. Near about people of 180 countries are using homeopathy now. Okay, so we should learn this topic by heart, and we should understand the process of allergic rhinitis to use our medicine very effectively. So let's begin. Today we'll discuss about allergic rhinitis, its definition, its types, its etiology, in which we'll discuss about predisposing factors and precipitating factors. We are also going to discuss about mechanism of allergic rhinitis. We will also discuss what is the pathological changes going on in the allergic rhinitis. Then clinical types of allergic rhinitis will be discussed, as well as symptoms, signs, how to diagnose, that is investigations which are required for allergic rhinitis, its treatment and its homeopathic management will be discussed in this lecture. So let's begin. What is allergic rhinitis? Allergic rhinitis is a very common disorder of the general population, and which occurs due to spasmodic attack of sneezing and rhinorrhea due to exposure to some allergens. Okay, so there are some allergens which are spreading in our environment, and when they enter inside our nasal cavity, then at that time those persons who are sensitive to those allergens, they develop type 1 sensitivity reaction. And because of this type 1 sensitivity reaction, we are going to see in detail what is type 1 sensitivity. Because of type 1 sensitivity disorder, there is increased flow and increased sneezing inside the nose. So let's see what are the etiological factors or causes which are responsible for development of allergic rhinitis. So first we see in which age you will see mostly the cases of allergic rhinitis. It is seen in cases of 15 years to 40 years. That means in the young age, the incidence of allergic rhinitis are more. But as the age progresses, that is from 40 to 50 years, the incidence gradually decrease. Then both sexes are affected equally, male as well as female, both are equally affected. Then what? Let's see what are the predisposing factors, which are predisposing factors which are responsible for development of allergic rhinitis. So here first is heredity. So if both the parents are allergic or both the parents are having allergic rhinitis, then chances of allergic rhinitis increases in the next generation also. Then hormonal. So as the incidence are starting from puberty and the peak reaches in the pregnancy, so we can say that there must be some hormonal angle or hormonal predisposition to the cases of allergic rhinitis. Then climate also causes an important factor, or it predispose the cases are more in case the cases of allergic rhinitis are more in the season of autumn. So climate which is humid, that also affect the person's susceptibility for the allergens. Then emotional causes are not of more importance in allergic rhinitis, but they are more important in vasomotor rhinitis. But yes, emotion can also play a role in allergic rhinitis also for the recovery of the patient. If the patient is undergoing stress, then recovery is late or delayed in those persons. Then let's see what are the precipitating or trigger factors in cases of allergic rhinitis. So these trigger factors are divided into two, that is exogenous and endogenous. Exogenous allergens are those which come from outside of the body, and endogenous allergens are those that are present inside our body. Okay, so let's see what are the exogenous bacteria, exogenous allergens. Exogenous allergens include inhalants, that is those substances which are spread in air. They can be inhaled inside our nose and they may cause allergies. These include house dust. This include house dust, pollen, then animal odor, feathers, molds, house dust and mites. Okay, so these are the common allergens which can be inhaled and cause allergy in the allergic rhinitis. Then ingestants like the foods like eggs or fish, milk or citrus fruits, they can trigger the allergic rhinitis. Then some contactants like some cosmetics or perfumes, they can also increase the chances of allergic rhinitis, or they can trigger the allergic rhinitis. Then there are some irritants like fumes or smoke in the environment, which can increase the chance of allergies. Then drugs, there are some certain drugs like aspirin, hypotensive drugs, iodides and some nasal drops, which can also affect the person's response, or which can trigger the allergic rhinitis. Then some infections are there, like some bacteria which and some products of inflammation may cause allergy, or they may be the secondary invaders. Now let's see what are the endogenous factors which are responsible for development of allergic rhinitis. So these things are within our body, and for example, intestinal helminths. Then tissue proteins in transudate and exudate. Okay, so these are responsible for development of or these are the endogenous factors which are responsible for allergic rhinitis. Then let's see what is the mechanism of allergic rhinitis. So students, as I have already said, that it is because of type 1 sensitivity reaction. Now what is type 1 sensitivity reaction? So whenever any allergen or foreign protein is introduced inside our nose, then immediately our dendritic cells are present inside our nose. So these dendritic cells, they immediately capture this allergen. But what happens is that afterwards these dendritic cells get attached to T lymphocyte. Okay, so dendritic cell which have engulfed the foreign pathogen or foreign protein, they get attached to the T lymphocyte. Now this T lymphocyte, they secrete cytokines. But when this is the normal reaction, but when these T lymphocyte are excessive in amount, then what happens? Then they give stimulus to B lymphocyte. Okay, when the T lymphocyte are excessive in amount, they invite B lymphocyte. Okay, now what happens with B lymphocyte? B lymphocyte produces, or B cells in, they produce IgE antibodies. Okay, so these IgE antibodies are mostly secreted in our eyes and our nasal mucosa. So when these IgE antibodies are excessively produced in our body, then they stimulate or they introduce, they invite mast cells. Okay, so these mast cells are the important factor for development of allergic rhinitis, because these mast cells produce histamines. Okay, now this histamine is degranulating histamine is produced, and when this histamine comes in contact with capillaries, it increases or it dilates the capillaries and it produces excessive amount of secretion or transudate from the capillaries. The permeability of capillary increases because of cytokines as well as because of this histamines. So that's why there is rhinorrhea, and because of irritation there is continuous sneezing attack inside the nose of the patient. Okay, so this is the basic mechanism of allergic rhinitis which is going on inside the nose. Now what pathology occurs inside the allergic rhinitis? So as far as pathology is concerned, there is infiltration of eosinophil and plasma cells and mast cells, T lymphocyte, B lymphocyte, okay, as we have already discussed. Then there is edema of the nasal mucous membrane. Then rhinorrhea, as we have discussed, there is increased secretion which is called as rhinorrhea. Then congestion, there is congestion of the nasal mucous membrane because of increased supply of or dilatation of capillaries. There is increased blood flow which causes congestion of the nasal mucous membrane. There is chance of superadded infection also with the opportunistic bacteria like Streptococcus and Staphylococcus. Then sometimes nasal polyps may also develop because of allergic rhinitis, because of increased secretion of the mucous membrane. Then likewise paranasal sinuses can also be affected because of allergic rhinitis. Then let's see what are the clinical types of the allergic rhinitis. So basically there are two types. First is seasonal and another is perennial. So in seasonal rhinitis, the person is getting affected only in particular season. That means the season when pollen grains are spreading inside the environment, like in autumn season, there is spread of pollens and the wind is blowing fast. So that's why the allergens spread inside the environment, and in this season the persons are getting affected mostly because of seasonal allergic rhinitis. But those persons who are affected throughout the year, they come under perennial allergic rhinitis. Okay, so that type is called as perennial allergic rhinitis. Now look at some symptoms of allergic rhinitis. So symptom includes irritation inside the nose and sometimes in eyes also, and there is a profuse watery discharges which is called as rhinorrhea, which comes out from nose. Then paroxysmal sneezing, whenever the allergen goes inside the nose, immediately it starts irritating and there is paroxysmal attack of sneezing. So patient may sneeze like 30 to 40 times also, or there is continuous sneezing for 10 to 15 minutes or more time also. Then nasal obstruction, so as there is congestion of nasal mucosa, there is also nasal obstruction. Then signs include acute, in acute stage the mucosa appears pale, while in chronic stage the mucosa becomes normal, but it may become bluish or purplish due to venous stasis. Then how to diagnose or what are the investigations of allergic rhinitis? So we can go for patch test, in which some allergens are injected inside our skin, okay, in our back, in different patches different allergens are injected, and in which injection the reaction appears is noted, and that means the person is allergic to that substance. If the reaction is there to the allergen, then that means the person is allergic to the that particular substance. So this is called as patch test, PATCH, patch test. Then what is the treatment? So as far as treatment is concerned, in allopathic mode they use antihistamines and steroids, maybe orally or locally, but they have their own side effects, because the steroids may cause their own side effects, and they slowly they decrease the smelling sensation and immunity inside the nose, and we know wherever we introduce steroids it decreases the immunity. So there is chance of secondary bacterial infection. It may start the process of atrophic rhinitis also inside the nose. Okay, so continuous use of steroids is also dangerous, and it should be avoided. Then histamines. The histamines, whenever we take histamines, there is feeling of drowsiness. The person becomes drowsy. Okay, so we should avoid using histamines also for longer time. Then best treatment for this is homeopathic treatment, because surgeries can also decrease the sensitivity, but they cannot eradicate the allergies. Okay, so we should go for homeopathic treatment. We have medicines like Allium Sepa, Arundo, Vaithya, Arsenic, Ipecac, Euphrasia. Okay, so these medicines are very, and then Amitriptyline is also an important remedy. So these medicines work very beautifully in cases of allergic rhinitis, and afterwards when this, in the acute attack we can use these medicines, but whenever there is we have to eradicate, then we should use constitutional anti-miasmatic remedies, so that we can completely eradicate the allergies from the system. Okay, so that's it from the today's presentation. You can use or you can solve this question at home. You can make notes, and the question which is asked is describe allergic rhinitis along with classification of rhinitis can be asked many times previously asked in many theory exams. Okay, so that's it from the today's presentation. Thank you very much.